This video explains the various settings and options offered by the Rules and Standards panel of ARCHICAD Stair Settings dialog. Let's activate the Stair Settings dialog and select the top item, Stair, in the tree structure on the left. The dialog's right side displays panels that contain settings related to the whole stair. The second of these panels is the Rules and Standards panel. Countries around the world have rules and standards on how various parts of stairs, such as treads, risers, landings, etc., can or must be constructed, and what kind of geometric conditions they must meet. This panel lets you select the type of rules and standards that you want your stair to comply with. In the panel, you can define ranges for possible input values in the Geometry and Positioning panel. During stair input, ARCHICAD will automatically create a stair that adheres to rules and standards you define here. In the Treads and Riser group, you can set either a minimum value, a maximum value, or both. This is done by checking the corresponding checkbox and entering a value in the field to its right. For example, in the riser height row, we check both the minimum and maximum checkboxes and enter 150 and 200 millimeters, respectively. We will then see that the possible values offered in the riser height field in the Geometry and Positioning panel all fall within this range. Similarly, we can set ranges for the going value, the 2 riser plus 1 going value, the riser per going ratio, the riser plus going value, and the stair pitch value. All these settings influence the riser height and going depth values. Based on the ranges specified here, ARCHICAD calculates the possible number or risers, riser height, and going depth values, and displays them in their respective fields in the Geometry and Positioning panel. One additional setting is the automatic landing length row, where you can specify a minimum value and a unit type. The specified value can be set to be calculated in either model units or number of goings. Whenever an automatic landing is generated as part of a stair, ARCHICAD makes sure its length is at least the minimum value specified here. In the Walking Line Calculation and Symbol group, walking line and tapered tread related settings are found. The walking line offset range lets you define a minimum offset value for the walking line from the left and right side of the stair. Using this field, you can specify that the walking line cannot be closer to the sides of the stair than the specified value. This will influence the minimum value you can enter into the walking line offset field. If a lower value is entered, it's automatically modified to the minimum value specified in the Rules and Standards panel. The walking line symbol at landing row lets you specify how the walking line is generated at landings. The two possible values are angled and rounded. The tapered tread width row lets you define the minimum value for the width of tapered treads at winders. When a turning of the stair is generated using winders, ARCHICAD makes sure that the dimension of the treads at their smallest width never goes below the value specified here. ARCHICAD includes a new preferences page related to this panel. Activate the options, Project Preferences, Stair Rules and Standards dialog. Here you can see a list of the first 6 rules of the Treads and Risers group in the Rules and Standards panel with a visibility toggle for each. If the visibility of a rule is turned off here, The given rule will not be displayed in the Stair Settings dialog. For example, if we set the visibility toggle of the last three rules to the hidden state, when we return to the Stair Settings dialog, we will see that these rules are now not displayed. This is a setting that may be used in template files for the proper implementation of Office standards.